Thank you. Thank you. flight to Sulasgeir Island.
Tired. Next.
What was the most stressful and most worrying part of the trip for you?
Before we could see Sulasgeir.
And what about going across the Rona? Do you have any thoughts on that? Are you quite happy with putting that fellow 10 miles?
Looking forward to getting some decent sleep and a nice bit of grass tonight.
Right, that's fine. Morty, what about you?
What about
you? How did you feel? Tired or quite fit or what?
Very fit.
Very fit. How heavy do you think your canoe has weighed this trip? Has it been the heaviest ever or do you think you've had it heavier?
Well, I think you'd be able to answer that one.
Well, I think it's absolutely ridiculous.
Ha ha ha!
work on doing?
It was my radio this morning. It just said the three canoes reached Rona yesterday. Reached Sulasgeir yesterday.
Ah, well, that's good. By God, you still fast on that island, eh? Well, Sulasgeir was absolutely amazing. Absolutely incredible place. We had been spewed on by all sorts of birds. And it was like going through a minefield with all the amount of birds that was there. Absolutely incredible. So we reckon we've got some good footage on that. Took a lot of photographs, so we should have quite a good show when we arrive back. Rona itself has been absolutely amazing as well. So we met a fishing boat that was on the coast here. We're speaking to the skipper. His eyes nearly popped out. He said, "Can I get on the hook?" Over to make inquiries, you know. We told him that we had come from the back, and he comes back. Get that,
copy that, Denny. What was the name of the fishing boat?
I couldn't honestly tell you. The angle that came in out of the pin was
Bountiful.
Hang on, it was the Bountiful.
Kinloch Mer.
UL Bountiful. I don't know the name of the number, but it was registered in Ellerfield. It's Bountiful. I don't really know what else it is. We'll be going around the island tomorrow, exploring the island, taking some filming and taking photographs. Then we'll get to the river for a bit. Fishing here and fishing. I think the wind's going to stay now. Scandal for us? Anything, everything going all right with the canoe club? Have you been speaking to anybody?
Yeah, I was speaking to them today. They're heading over to Valtis at half past six, and Kate and Don went over this morning just after 10 o'clock.
That's great. Sulasgeir.
Yes, I told them right after I phoned you.
Good stuff, guys. Just as long as it's just to so they know that if any sponsors ask that we're on schedule.
And I'm phoning Valtis when I leave the boat.
That's great. Well, I'll pass you back on the morning. Okay.
Thank you.
recorded for us then? I've had a good day. Well, this is it. I mean, you can't please everybody. It's one of these things. If we had to make use of the weather, if we had stayed till this morning, there's no way that we'd have set off the boat as it was doing. So north to northeast from 5 to 6. So pretty much every day we're just spotted in the north. The wind is going to be blowing northeast of us for the rest of the week. Well, I don't really know, but it's certainly starting to ease a little bit. It's not too bad up here. It's maybe a foot, maybe a foot five. But I think it's going to be blowing pretty cold.
There's a few, just the same as it was on the Saturday. When we came round here on the Saturday, it was just the same as that. Maybe just a little bit worse.
Aye, what wind direction and wind speed do you reckon it's going to be at now?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Canoe Club on Rona, 1992.
It is 3:15, 38 knots, not so much delay. 3:15, 38 knots, Rona. Having a rest day. After all, I've been traveling for a long time.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
important passage to Butter Lewis. The final passage is approximately 14 hours, and we should be there about 7:30. On behalf of the expedition, I would like to thank special thanks for committee members, mainly Sheena, Joe, and Steen for their tremendous effort in the fundraising. And a special thanks to Johnny McCaskey, who's been our shore-based operator, who has done a marvellous job. And thanks to him also for the use of the video and all the photography equipment. And a special thanks also to our film operator, Murray Campbell, to Stornoway Coast Guard for coordinating the progress of the trip and informing all who concerned. It's a northeasterly 4 to 5. Shipping forecast at 0033 was northeasterly 4 to 5, occasionally 6. So that's not too bad because the wind will be right above stern, hopefully. But there is a threat that will be up to the east where we're playing, and that's not going to happen.
call the Coast Guard station.
We'll do that.
Don't push me in the sea. Derek Graham, you're the group leader, team leader. How did it go?
Very well, absolutely first class, couldn't have gone better. We had good weather going out, and then good weather going across to North Rona, and then the weather started breaking. We reckoned that the wind was going to actually veer around to the southeast, so we had to make a run for it today. 4 to 5, occasionally 6 was what the weather was doing, but quite good.
Tell me the story of the trip then.
Sorry about this, just do that. The light changed.
Well,
go on.
Tell me the story of the trip then.
Well, the object of the trip was basically to explore Sulasgeir and North Rona, and at the same time try and raise funds for the canoe club for the purchase of new equipment, new canoes for the swimming pool, which we used to teach the kids canoeing during the winter months when they've got nothing else to do. And we had a great time going round Sulasgeir, good weather, we paddled right through the island and then crossed to North Rona. When we got to Rona, we rested for a few hours and then got the tents up, called up the coast guards and then circumnavigated the island.
Some good scenery to be seen out at Sulasgeir and Rona. Could you tell us a little about it?
Yes, absolutely incredible. Sulasgeir is just absolutely amazing. There's so much birds. You can hardly walk. It's like a minefield. You've got to dodge them. Walk around them all the time. There's a lot of eggs about, so you've got to be very careful where you put your feet. So noisy. We couldn't sleep through the night because of the noise. There's no grass, so you can't put your tent there. So we just had to sleep amongst the birds and the ledges. And on Rona is an amazing island. It's green, and the scenery there is fantastic, absolutely fantastic. And it's about a mile long and a mile wide, so...
You explored some caves there, tell me about that.
Yes, these caves were absolutely amazing. Some of them were going in very, very deep, some of the deepest ones I've ever paddled through. And the seals were so thick that we could hardly pull our paddles through the water without touching them. There was just hundreds of them. The sea conditions out there were quite rough, so we had to really watch what we were doing. There was no landings on the west side that we were going to.
So how do you feel now?
Quite well, a lot better than I thought I would. We did a lot of training for this, so the 13-hour passage is not really all that demanding.
Will you lend us the video for a day?
Yes, no problem.
Thank you very much. I've got that on tape.
Can we get a seat?
Okay.
hand side, Wollihusen on the left hand side from me. Murdy, what was the highlight of the trip for you?
Well, just after 3 years of talking about doing this trip, and myself and Derek had been always talking about it for that long, and we just got the breaks with the weather this year and all the planning that Derek put into it, and just getting out and seeing the islands by canoe, it was really something, probably something that will never happen again.
Willie, from your point of view, how fit were you to begin with? How did the planning work out?
I trained quite hard to get fit for this trip. Obviously a long distance in one pull, you got to be sure you can do it before you set off. The highlight, I think, was arriving back, having completed the trip.
How do your legs feel?
Sorry?
How do your legs feel?
Very sore. Don't think I'll ever sit down again.